I am not alone. I'm actually with somebody who is very near and dear to my heart, Miss
Stone.
Miss Tracy Stone is here. Special arrangement to get her here. And it's really important that today I have a partner because what we're gonna talk about is bugs.
Oh God.
And I can tell you up and down how amazing bugs is, but that's my point of view. Some people don't feel the same. So as somebody who we taught together for several years and bugs always came up as part of our curriculum, this is an opportunity that we can discuss not only why bugs are important, but how you can do bug exploration with touching.
And without touching.
What grosses you out?
Like the squishiness of it. Or like the creepy crawliness of it.
One really great part that I admire dearly about Tracy is bug exploration actually happened very naturally in our class 2 years in a row. Tracy was able to show the kids not only like she's totally comfortable in her skin and she's totally comfortable with not being a fan of something. And for them to see that maybe they were a little bit braver, a little bit braver than Tracy, it gave them even more confidence. We actually have tobacco hornworms, which is actually really cool because of the fact that there's a lot of companies that you can order bugs online from. And there's actually specific companies that will go ahead and take in consideration where you live and will send bugs that you may find outside in your environment. And with that being said, it's this really fun exploration later to be out and about with the kids doing an activity, and they're not only able to, one, recognize what these bugs are, but then pull out all this past knowledge that you already taught them. These little guys are all over the Midwest. Tracy, what do you see?
I see green.
You see green?
Like a lightish green, and they have stripes and like black little tiny dots down each like section. So big, and there's like that pointy horn at the end, and there's those tiny feet.
I'm gonna give you some information that may scare you. Over 90% of all living things on Earth are insects.
Right.
And if I was to tell Tracy how many bugs are in her house, or how,
no.
I'm not gonna tell you, or
so
how
funny.
Many bugs are she encounters on a daily basis, it would blow your mind. So with that being said, it's the first thing the kids actually start exploring because it's so accessible. And it's really important for them to explore because in a day and age where we tend to be really, we tend to be more spectators when it comes to learning, bugs and digging in dirt is a hardcore active exploration. And that kind of active exploration and that active questioning is really important for this age. Okay, in here, we have vesp beetles. And vesp beetles are really cool because not only are they beetles, but they eat wood and they're really fun later when they die naturally to break them open and find like wood chips inside of them, and the kids are like, wow, that's where all the wood went. This is a wonderful time to insert vocabulary. You can do an entire journal about what they're doing on that day. Tracy, what are some of the things that you would do with this beetle when we had him in class? The kids really loved him, and you're not the biggest fan. What kind of stuff would you do?
Like you said, I guess talking about them a lot, and it's really nice because the kids get to lead that more than me, because I would just ask them questions and they have to answer, like, what does it feel like? Or, you know, what does it feel like crawling on your body? Or what are things that you see like really up close? And I can't answer those questions. So they really take the lead and they kind of start leading that exploration.
Now Tracy, you can take a closer look. What do you notice? And I'll even grab its brother or sister. And the cool thing about these beetles is they actually make noise. So you can discuss, like, are the beetles talking? What are they saying?
Something else that was kind of fun is, like, you can do a lot of research on them, but like Rachel said, they're so active that we actually, I think, made fictional stories about them too. Like, that's something we did with their journals is that, like, you know, after you go home, what do you think they do?
The amount of information that our children retained from doing this kind of bug play was
amazing.
Yeah. They became bug experts.
They did.
They could pull out the most random Snapple fact out of nowhere and entertain everybody, and then it would be really great because it's like, we did that.
Yeah. Seeing how interested the kids were, I think, made me interested. Not to, like, want to touch them, but to want to explore them as well and learn more about it. So I feel like I learned a lot during the bug explorations too.
And by the end of the class, every single child touched a bug.
Yes.
Every single child
held it in their hand.
Held it in their hand and took away some kind of information.